climate affects us all, so having a good idea of what the climate may be like over the coming months can help us plan ahead.
This is where the Bureau of Meteorology's climate outlooks are such a valuable tool. Knowing how to interpret them is the key.
While a weather forecast can tell you that tomorrow may be 18 degrees and cloudy, the climate outlook can't be this specific because it is looking so much further ahead. What they can do is tell us the odds of something occurring. For example,
last summer the outlook said the odds of wetter than average conditions for southeast Queensland were 35%. This also meant that there was a 65% chance of it being drier than average. And while it was indeed dry, there was no absolute guarantee it would come out that way. It's a bit like stacking a roulette wheel with more red or black. You're not guaranteed a win because there is always that element of chance. But you know that in the long run, having the odds in your favour will mean you'll come out ahead.
There are many examples of using the odds to inform decisions. A farmer may choose to change crops based upon how strongly the outlook favours dry conditions. A retailer may decide to bring in the spring clothing lines a few weeks earlier if warmer than average temperatures are likely. And emergency services may choose to change their fire management plans depending on the likelihood of a hot, dry summer. The accuracy of the outlook varies during the year and from location to location, so it's worth looking at our accuracy maps whenever you use a climate outlook.
Let's say you're interested in the maximum temperature outlook for November to January. If you are in the Gold Coast area, the outlook suggests a high chance of exceeding the average temperature for this period. Looking at the historical accuracy map, you learn that at this time of year, the model has performed well in southeast Queensland with up to 75% accuracy. In contrast, outlooks for parts of the Northern Territory have had limited success. Just remember, these maps show the average accuracy over a 30-year period. During strong climate events such as El Niño or La Niña, you may actually have a higher degree of confidence in the outlooks. Check out the Climate Influences section to get our climatologist's view on what's driving our climate.
Planning ahead with climate outlooks can help you make smarter choices and stack the odds in your favour. For the Bureau of Meteorology, I'm Andrew Watkins.